Right, so I've tried to make an intro to this video multiple times, but I just can't do it. So if you're my sister Kailey, this video is for you. I hope you enjoy. If you're not my sister Kailey, welcome. I hope you enjoy my college experience. Wednesday, and I'm moving. This is too close to my body. I'm moving in tomorrow, as you know. And so right now, I'm headed out to go get my stuff from Grandma's house, and then I'm gonna, well, that's false. I'm going to Walgreens to pick up some photos on a street that I don't know. So Google Maps, and then I'm gonna head to Grandma's. Get the rest of my stuff. And it's freaking raining. All right, Kaylee, this is half the damage that's on the hat. We're putting it in Grammy and Granddad's trunk. Got it all packed up. Oh, almost. All right, we got one more bag. Got the one bag. And we also got here. Yeah, I've been up since 6 a.m. because I helped Madeline move her bed. Like, I helped her bunk the bed. And so I'm kind of over moving already, but here we are. I just got done packing, or not packing, what am I talking about? This is how exhausted I am. Just got done, you know, moving in, not completely, just like small things, but it's already like 12:35. I'm hungry, so I'm going to go get food probably, and also I'm at Grammy and Granddad's right now, so I'm dropping off their car keys and everything, and then I'm pack the rest of my room and decorate it, and I'll probably show you once it's all finished or whatever. All right, Kaylee, so today is my first day of classes. It's like 9:30 and my class starts at 10, so I need to get going. But I'm going to show you the rest of my room. My roommate was out of the room, so this is the deal. Got some dirty laundry, but we got the cart set up. We got the desk set up. It looks like a mess, but I swear I'll fix it. Then I got my bed that's not made, but I set up lines. And I got my photos up there and my art. So that's pretty much the deal. It's raining outside. By the way, I guess you don't know. It's raining outside for safe classes, and it's been raining all day. Today I went to my Italian class again, and I went to my Film 100 class, which is like scaring me. Didn't really seem like a 100 class because I felt very underqualified. There's a lot of writing apparently, and I'm scared because I don't have enough brain cells for that at the moment. Also, I've had like zero time yesterday and today to do like anything besides school, so it's kind of scary, but I'm hoping like tomorrow will be different just because I have class in the evening. Like, I just have like the two classes of the day, and then I have the rest of the time to do whatever I need to do, which is study for Italian. But yeah. Oh, we picked out Italian names today. I'm Sophia. So yeah. Yeah. If you're wondering who I am now.
The name
Sophia.
And the address is 221B Baker Street.
Anyway, I'm gonna go out and like get some school supplies. It's been a rough week. I do not adjust well to these things. It's okay. I'll get more friends. I don't know. I've been feeling like I haven't gotten any friends lately, so that's super, you know, nice or whatever. But I don't know. I just feel like I haven't been getting any friends, any new friends per se. So I feel like very discouraged by that. But also it's only been a week. Today though, I went to like walk Madeline to her class or whatever because I was bored, and this is like 5 minutes ago, but I walked Madeline to her class, and then Max Emerson, this guy that I've known since like second grade, he invited me to go to the football game with him and just like talk trash on football players. So that's kind of everything I need in life right there. So I'll probably end up doing that. Now I feel better because I'm like doing stuff with people instead of just like sitting alone doing nothing, because I've had like no time to do anything today, or not today, but like this week. So yeah, that's today. Sorry for the shaky camera. I clearly don't know what I'm doing. Today has been nice because I haven't really had time to do like anything else this week, and then I studied for Italian 2 days ago for 5 hours. So this class is gonna be work, is what I'm saying basically. And then I really haven't done much else besides that. I had fish and chips at ease today, if you want to know that. That's what I had. And then I don't know. I don't feel at home right now. I just feel very out of place, like I don't belong here yet. And it's not about knowing where to go to things. I know Lawrence very well. It's just like I don't have a family here, and I don't mean like family and like mom and dad and Aunt Jody and them. I just don't feel like I have a lot of friends or people that I can hang out with, nor have I had time to do any of that. Plus my film 100 class is so difficult. I didn't realize that it was gonna be that I'm very underqualified for it, and it's a film 100 class. I sit there every day and I think, well, twice a week, I guess. I sit there twice a week and think, I wish there were a film 90, because he just talks very fast about things I don't understand yet. So that's just kind of how that goes. College life sucks. I had a little cry session over the weekend. I was not having it because, I didn't know why I was sad. I was like, I shouldn't be sad. I literally just saw everyone, because I went and saw like Kale on Thursday, and then saw like Amanda on Friday. That's who I saw. I saw Amanda and Andreessa and Aunt Roxanne on Friday, and then on Saturday, I saw Caden because I went to Rimrock, and I also saw Zoe, and yeah, I was like, I shouldn't be, like, unhappy at all, because I've just seen all these people. Mom was like, I think it's because you were feeling the love, and now you're just like, I have nobody here. I was like, you're probably correct, so what can I do about it? It sucks that I have, like, nobody here that I really, really like can be in company with, but I'm trying to change that. In early October, I went to my first comedy show. I went alone, but it was still really fun. It's 8:57 in the morning. I woke up at 8:30, and I'm actually having a proper breakfast this morning.
We should be really, really proud.
This portion of the video is what I like to call the study abroad saga. So fun, I want to watch it in 3D. It was about this time of the year that I started study abroad research, and so I was very, very stressed out. And this is me complaining for 30 minutes about life and study abroad and bad advisors. So here's some gems from that rant.
I almost said decrease my sentence because college is a prison. I have no idea what I'm doing, and it seems like somebody should know what they're doing, you know? Like, people at McDonald's have a more stable career than I do at this point. Like, adults are lying to me or something, and that it's just all a sham, a corporate sham, and this is America, you know what I mean? But is it? I don't... I feel crazy, basically, how I started this video. I feel like I'm going crazy.
Shit. I can't do that, because I still need four. Oh, Jesus Christ. You're seeing plans fall apart in front of your eyes.
No.
Oh my god. I don't know what to do. Well, I don't know what to do now. I feel like trying. Oh my god. Okay.
Apparently, for the past hour, I would say, I've been trying to motivate myself to go out on a run. But I just, like, I'm so lazy right now. Like, I just want to sit and eat cookie dough or something. Not productive at all. So, hoping that if I just get dressed to go, then it'll be good.
I did, in fact, go on this run, and my room's really dirty, so moving swiftly along, this is me writing my paper and what the dorm lobby looks like, and those are the lobby rules, our community rules, with important things like flushing the toilets and hitting K-State, and that's the rest of the space, I guess. And my paper again. Fun. And that's me! So, fun. Extra fun.
Today's your birthday, Kailey. So happy birthday. Not like I already didn't send you a message by the time this is actually like a full-on video. It'll be like months past your birthday, but happy birthday. So Italian, I'm doing better in Italian because I just ain't. Life's hard. So, the academics are doing alright. It's the life that's hard. And there's the KU game tonight. Didn't go to it because I just don't. I just need to, like, lay down and relax. I need to, like, read a book, but I haven't done that yet. But I really need to read a book. I feel like that would help me. It would make me feel better. So, yeah. I'm cleaning my sheets for the second time.
At the end of November, I set up some holiday decorations and I also bought some Sprite cranberry.
I don't wanna do this. That's how I feel, like, all the time right now. Not vacant. There's usually like one or more people in there, and then I feel left out of a group, and then it's just sad because I'm in the lobby alone. Again, but I have to be quiet because also there are quiet hours, so I can't be, you know, like screaming. like go to like no place is really open that late where I can just like sit there for hours and hours. Maybe like Papa Kino's, they're open to like midnight, but also like after midnight, what am I gonna do? And I also can't scream in Papa Kino's, so.
So after whatever you called that last clip, I ended up going to the bar, which is a surprisingly good place to study, and it's open till 2 a.m., so that's also great.
Oh my gosh, my windshield's so dirty. But look how pretty it is! Can you see that? Oh my goodness. They had a candy cane tree back there, dude. It was so pretty. I love Lawrence when it's lit up like this. It's like the prettiest thing ever. I'm just gonna like set my phone here while I drive for a bit.
Tiny tots, tiny tots, with their eyes all aglow, will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way.
This is where I would like to take a quick interlude, if you will, and tell you about the time I sat on the ledge of my parents' apartment, and it was the night of the Harry Styles Fine Line release. It was Friday the 13th, there was a full moon, and I saw a shooting star. So, 10 out of 10 experience.
Yesterday, I took my final four, my Black Cultural Films class, which was a knockout. I took the test in 18 minutes, and it was so easy. The lowest I'm gonna get is a 90% on that. Pretty stoked about it. The Italian final, different story. We'll just see on that one. I really don't know if it went sort of okay or if I bombed it. Homie of the week is Professor Johnson, okay? So let's just say that. He is respected.
We're just gonna skip January because it didn't exist. Nothing happened. And but in February, I missed class, which, to be fair, wasn't the first time. So I made that lecture up on a very cold morning. And look at that little dude, just chilling. And later that month, I went to the KU-KSU game, and the student section made a flag of flags. Enjoy these last few moments.
My week has been I rated a 23%. Can I rate on a percentage scale? I don't know.
This is when shit starts hitting the fan. A quick memoriam to my fellow classmates. So I ended up having to move out in March because there was, you know, a worldwide pandemic. And so this is me doing that. Honestly thought that was true until I gave this motherfucker like a month or two. This is getting kind of ridiculous at this point. Yo, my cat died in a global pandemic, took over my life, and I put out some music that nobody liked. So I got really sad and bored at the same time, and that's why I'm like low-key fuck 2020. Still sad, still ain't got no money. I ain't got a watch up on my wrist. I just did some shit I gotta fix. Low-key fuck 2020.
I
Girls, wait.
Hold up. Okay, that was a lie. The
problems are bad. Honestly, probably not that bad. When I compare to some shit. Currently at the soccer fields at like Shawnee Mission. I wanted to like go kick around and just do something. Because of the quarantine, I feel crazy because I've just been in like the same room in my house for in the apartment, not even a house, it's an apartment, in an apartment for like I don't even know how long. So I was like, oh, I'll go out and kick a soccer ball around or something, and it'll be fine. They put the goals against each other, so now I can't do anything, so. Yeah. Anyway, I thought I would just, like, update you on what's happening, because a lot has happened while I'm on the soccer field, because I'm on the soccer field for no reason now. Because the goals are, like, not here. Basically, if I wanted to sum up my quarantine time and how like school's been going, it is basically that I have cried the past two nights consecutively, so that's cool. It's a lot of stress, and I'm very stressed out. I really need to work on it, so I'll work on it. And it's so not fun. It's so not fun being quarantined. I feel like prison is awful. Prison is awful just for the pure fact that you have to be in the same building for, like, whatever your sentence is. And I haven't even, like, just stayed inside the house, I guess. Like, I'm able to do things, just, like, within certain social distancing type things, but I'm just flabbergasted about how easy it was for me to lose my mind. It's super easy. Too easy, in fact. So, yeah. I'm taking Italian. I'm not learning much. It's awful. What else? I don't know what's happening in my 200 class, my FMS 200 class. That class, did I mention it's a class? That thing, I don't even know what to call it. I just feel like I've said class too many times in the past 30 seconds. I don't know what's happening in it. None of the stuff, like, she has a syllabus up, and it says that we need to take quizzes, but they're not uploaded. There's no quiz on Blackboard or anything, so then I'm like, oh, I must be crazy. I must be stupid or something, and they're there, and I'm just missing out, or I missed an email thread that she sent. I have no idea what's happening in this class, so I'm a little worried about it. I'm not super worried about the class, because I'm like, at least I don't have to do any work at the moment. But, yeah, anyway. I just got a Snapchat from one of my Italian mates. I don't know what to call them. Italian classmate. That's what it is. A classmate. See, I'm losing brain cells. So that I just got a Snapchat from him, so that can't be good. It can't be good. It can't be good information. Yep. I'm just talking about nothing at this point. Anyway, those are all my classes. Not all my classes. I have other classes too. I have to like make a movie and stuff, but I'm not actually worried about that. It's like my biggest project that I have to do. I'm not even worried about. I also have to write a paper in English, but am I worried about that? No. I don't know why. I will be when it's like due in 24 hours and I haven't started on it, but maybe this time I'll actually start on time. you know? We'll see. I don't know. Anyway, that's been my update. I hope there is never a global pandemic ever again during my college education, because it is trash. It is trash. You should feel so lucky, Kailey, and Kate, if Kate's here watching this, that you never had to do this. What am I, like, and this isn't, I'm going through all this struggle and hardship because, it's the worst thing that could ever happen. It's bad, but it's not the worst thing that could happen to me, but I'm just saying that, you should be so lucky that you, that wasn't structured correctly. That sentence did not work. You're lucky that you never had to do this. And so, feel grateful is the message. Yeah, I don't know. It's awful. It's awful. And I don't even know, I'm not even going to get a reward at the end of this. It's not like you successfully learned through a pandemic. Here's your Jimmy John's gift card or something. No, I'm not getting anything out of this. I can't, I guess maybe I'll put it on a resume. I'll be like, hey, you want me? I learned in college when there was a pandemic. They're not going to care. And what kind of thing is that? To put that on a resume. A resume. Like, people would think I went crazy in 2020 and then never recovered because I put that on my resume. So I don't think there's any helping me at all. Yeah, I need to be more positive. This is depressing. I don't have the coronavirus, so that's a positive thing, I think. Well, I know it's a positive thing. I don't for sure know that I don't have the coronavirus because I haven't been tested, but I seem to be all right, and Mom and Dad also seem to be all right, and so I'm going to go with we all don't have the coronavirus because we're not dying. And there's your conclusion. I made a hypothesis, I did the research, and that is the conclusion. Thank you everybody for watching. I'm a scientist, so I need to wrap this up. I'm gonna go home now because I can't even play soccer. I was actually playing soccer. I can't kick a ball around into a goal like I want to. So, I'm gonna go home. I'm probably going to eat instead of doing anything productive. I'm gonna try to find Twilight. Any of them at this point, because I've searched through every single disc in our house and I can't find any of the Twilights, and so I'm starting to think that it was your fault, Kailey, sister dearest. I feel like you took it to Quentin's house so that one of his brothers could watch it or something, and then you never got it back, and now I can't watch Twilight. So I'm gonna have to pay $16 to have a Twilight marathon on YouTube unless I find these discs. And I'm going to find these discs, because $16 is ridiculous. Not really. It's actually kind of reasonable, but I don't want to pay it, because I'm not earning any money. So, yes. That's what I'm going to do. Welcome to my life. I have nothing better to do. Also, I can't find Harry Potter. That's another thing. I was like, oh, I can't watch Twilight, I'll watch Harry Potter. Can't find Harry Potter, so now I'm like, what do? I can't watch Twilight, I can't watch Harry Potter. Anyway, I don't know what to do with my life. Study abroad is stressful. Nobody tells you that, but I'm telling you that. study abroad is stressful. There's so much paperwork. And in a pandemic, it's even more stressful than it should be. So, study abroad, but be prepared for stress if you're a stressed out person. Maybe if you're a normal person, it won't be stressful, but if you're like me, you will be stressed out. 100%. That is a fact. It's number 5 in the book of facts. You'll find it there. Anyway, bye. I'm gonna sign off.
Just like
bye.
For like 2 minutes. Low key, fuck 2020. Shit, I gotta fix. Shit, I gotta fix. Low key, fuck 2020.